Hallo, hallo, hallo. Today is November 14, 2021. At least for me. Maybe not for all of you. Depends on where you live. In problem 123, we derived. And there was no question about that derivation. It's completely okay that if the mirror were in the ISS, International Space Station, whether it had a constant velocity or whether it would stand still makes no difference. We just assume that the mirror stands still. If then light bounces off, then the mirror must have kinetic energy as a result of that. And I derived how much that was. Simple, straightforward physics. There is a force on the mirror, and the mirror is pushed out. That is the basic idea between what people call solar sails. Even being used by NASA. In other words, you shine a laser beam, say from Earth or from another satellite, onto a, call it a sail, and you make the light reflect off that sail. Even if you didn't reflect it, but if the light were absorbed, in both cases, the sail will start moving. If you keep sending photons on it, it will continue to be accelerated because there will be a force on it all the time. Therefore, it will increase its speed, called solar sail. So I derived that in the case of problem 123, that the mirror, after the reflections, would gain a kinetic energy of 2 times 10 to the minus 15 joules. And the question then was, where did this energy come from? It can only have come from the photons that reflected, because the photons that come in have a momentum P, and therefore the momentum of the photons that are reflected must be lower than this P. That means that the energy is lower, because the energy of photons is the momentum times C. So when the momentum goes down, the energy goes down. So that is, it must happen there. Why does that happen? That is a wonderful piece of physics. And we call that a relativistic Doppler shift. You ready for that? So I am not going to calculate the loss of energy of the mirror. All I will need for the relativistic Doppler shift is the speed of this mirror after the reflection. That's all I need. And I grind this through relativistic, what we call relativistic redshift, and then we can calculate how much energy of the photons is lost when they come to me and reach me. Ready? Okay, so the energy is Pc, it is also h times f. H is Planck's constant, f is the frequency. The wavelength is the speed of light divided by f. So when the frequency goes down, the wavelength goes up. Now, you are here, and here is the mirror. And the mirror moves away from you with speed v, which is r 2 times 10 to the minus 7 meters per second. The light that is reflected off the mirror, let us say it has a wavelength lambda 0. And the fact that it has a whole spectrum of wavelengths is irrelevant, because what comes will hold for all wavelengths. Okay? So, it radiates a wavelength lambda 0, therefore a frequency f0. What I receive here is a different wavelength. I receive lambda, and I can calculate what that lambda is using the relation for relativistic Doppler shift. I derived that in one of my lectures. And what follows here is only correct if the speed is much, 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 much smaller than the speed of light. Only then will my equations hold. Trust me, it is really much, much lower than the speed of light. It's only 2 times 10 to the minus 7 meters per second. All right. In that case, the relativistic Doppler shift is the lambda that I receive is 1 plus beta times lambda 0. And beta is V over C. Since the speed of the mirror is 2 times 10 to the minus 7 meters per second, beta is 6.7 times 10 to the minus 16. Way smaller than 1. So that means that the wavelength that I will receive is larger than lambda 0. 1 plus beta. 1 plus beta. So the frequency is lower by 1 minus beta times f0. Remember, if f goes up, lambda goes down. If lambda goes up, f goes down. So this frequency is lower than f0. This wavelength is larger than lambda 0. So the energy, which is linearly proportional to the frequency, will also go down by the same fraction as the frequency goes down. So the energy that I will receive from light reflected off the moving mirror is 1 minus this times E0. Since E0 was 3 joules, remember we calculated that the energy in the radiation that comes in is 3 joules, and what comes back very close to 3 joules, but just a hair less. So the 3 joules has an energy loss then of 3 times 6.7 times 10 to the minus 16. And 3 times 10, 6.7 times 10 to the minus 16, lo and behold, is 2 times 10 to the minus 15 joules. So now you see the beauty of the physics. Because the mirror recedes from me, moves away from me with a minutely small speed, the energy of the photons that come back to me must go down. Relativistic Doppler shift called redshift. Redshift means the frequency goes down and the wavelength goes up. So now you see a complete, consistent picture of what the motion of the mirror does to the reflected photons. Isn't it wonderful? What looked at first as some kind of a mystery, I mean, how can it possibly be that these photons that come back lose energy? They have to lose energy because of Einstein's relativistic Doppler shift. Okay, have a nice day. If this is a little bit too difficult for you, don't feel bad. Don't feel bad. Relativistic Doppler shift is not part of JEE Advanced even. Relativistic Doppler shift is generally college physics, second year, yeah, in a few cases maybe even third year. I cover it in one of my lectures, probably 802, but I don't remember. Maybe it is 803. I don't have a good memory because I gave these 94 MIT lectures how many years ago? Oh, roughly 20 years ago. Okay? So, enjoy life. Don't feel bad if this is above your horizon. It is above most people's horizons anyhow. And for sure, we'll be friends. That's always a given. That is a very strong conservation law of physics. It is the strongest conservation law of physics.